highly satisfactory. Flame slash! Searing slash! Searing slash!
Perfectly executed.
Your help. Take care. Hello there. Some post came for you. See you later.
You!
Flames!
Slash!
Perfectly executed. We'll be right back.
All right, there we go. Can you hear me now? Sorry about that, everybody. I forgot to turn the audio included in broadcast back on in the settings there. Alright, so basically, what I was saying before you could hear me was that we're going to do some side stuff. What I did at first, before this one treasure map that we just finished, was we did the next Improving Upon Perfection side quest that expanded the monster metal case even further with another 4 slots. And part of the reason we're doing this is, as you can see, we have a red outfit instead of a blue outfit on the main character now, and that is because off-screen I actually finished the side quest to get his alternate costume, so I'm just doing a couple of side things to show it off here for a moment before we continue the story. Awesome. Yeah, I forgot to go back into the settings before I started the stream and turn the allow it to be heard through broadcasting back on. Alright, so as you guys can see, instead of wearing blue, he's wearing red. This is the alternate costume that took me a while to get for the male main character. It's just red. That's all it is. It's just a color swap. Yeah, she said that she had watched the recording of it later. Okay, so actually, I'll do one more map area, and then what I'll do that stinks, Brave. Sorry to hear that. I was just basically saying that the reason that we're wearing red instead of blue is the red color swap was basically the alternate outfit from that one side quest. So I figured I'd do a couple side missions wearing it to show it off, because I wasn't able to complete that side mission on stream, but I was able to finish that side quest off of stream, so I have it now to show. So basically what I'm going to do is I'm going to do one more of those maps, because I want to throw Bianca back in to work on her a little bit. And then I'm going to show the scene that happened at the top of the Pinnacle of Light Tower that we went through, that told us where to go next, and then we'll continue the story. That way you kind of see what happened story-wise before this point in the game. And I will show something else, too. And I just did the map for the fight against the Gigantus reel. So we just got another special map from that fight, and that's what we're going to be seeing right now. But as you can see over here, where the Pinnacle of Light Tower was is gone. But now we have the Trial Isle that we can go to again. And basically, going to the trial aisle, you can sit here and redo the Pinnacle of Light Tower. Since the Pinnacle of Light Tower's been destroyed, this is how you redo the fights in there as you go to the trial aisle. And he'll send you through a portal that takes you back to the tower. Alright, so this is the first actual fight that I did off-screen with those three hunter mechs that I mentioned in the one cutscene. Yeah, I agree with you there, Brave. Hopefully it'll settle down. Alright, but first... I actually have to head down into here anyway first, because I have to head into here to switch someone out.
Well, hello. And what can I do for you?
Alright, so let's go in here, and we're going to switch out Alina with Bianca.
Margo, how can I help?
Oop, nope, we're done with her.
Don't be a stranger.
Okay. Oh yeah, I don't blame you there, Brave. Okay, so I'm going to do this map because, like I said, this is the fight with the three Haunter mechs in the Colosseum where you met Terry that I did off-screen that I never showed. So we'll do this fight again, except we'll do it with Terry, Jessica, and Bianca, three people that we didn't have at the time. And basically, you're just sitting here in the Colosseum and you're fighting three Haunter mechs.
Understood.
Alright, this might take me a bit because I haven't played this game in about a month and a half. Tension here. Oh wow, they already took one out for me. Nice. There goes another one.
Go Super Saiyan!
And there we go. I think after finals are over, I'm going to... After I'm finishing the game, before I need help at the anime convention. Yeah, and I kind of had to focus on that fight, so I couldn't spend too much time looking at the computer screen to figure it out. Yes, use your coup de grace when the fight's already over. Oh, hello, another treasure chest. Let me guess, this is going to be another map that they can't read right away. Yep. A full-color laser-printed map.
Perfectly executed!
Hmm. I know, real, right? Just for the swag. I actually got Twitch alerts set up, but I don't think I can get them working, streaming through the PS4. But I do have it set up so it'll show me when people subscribe, which will be nice. Alright, so I'm just gonna go through and work, see if I wanna raise anyone's, spend anyone's points right now before I change his outfit and show what's been going on. Increases maximum MP. Cause like I've been noticing that like a lot of these abilities that have that cost like 15, 16, or 20 points are actually really well worth it. It just takes a number of levels to get the points to use to actually purchase them. Greatly increased deafness. Darn it, he's still missing skill points for that. Oh, wait a minute, let's see what do we got over here I could do, potentially. Thinking of something for my next. The next time I get everyone on skip. Ah, I see, Brave. Alright, so he's gonna need 5 more skill points to learn Falcon Slash. Supposedly that's gotta be some pretty sweet ass ability for him to learn, cause he's the only character that's had a skill up in his spells and abilities so far that's cost 15 points. Okay, anything down here I want to give you? Alright, that's worth having. Can I give you this? Yeah, let's give you Frizz. Definitely. Jessica, we can give you Crackle if we wanted. Hustle Dance Bolster would be pretty nice. Serpent's Bite Sharpener extend the area of effect from Serpent's Bite. That's not too bad either. A Lash Lick. Sure thing, Brave. I would be happy to join if you wanted me to. Extends high tension. Alright, we should give her that. Alright, that's that for that. Alright, now I'm gonna put him back in the blue, just because I prefer his blue. I prefer his standard blue outfit to the red alternate costume. And now we are going to actually go and watch the scene that we saw at the top of the Pinnacle of Light. Alright, let's see if I can find where this is. Alright, I think this is the first one. Yep.
Wow. This place ain't half grand. Do you reckon that's the Oracle over there? could be, but I don't see no goddess. Maybe she's not in.
Wait! Behold!
Child of light. Brave companions. You have done well to guard this, my sanctum, from harm. You have my thanks.
The goddess of light. This is Lella. Hear me, O goddess! I beg you! A comrade of ours has been swallowed by the darkness. We seek your counsel. Can she be returned to her former self?
There is a way. Your companion can be restored. And the benighted world tree saved thereby.
She can. And the world tree too. They can truly both be saved.
However, the means to do so is yet beyond you. You require a greater power. The true power of the light. Child of light, north and east of this place, the Shrine of Scales lies hidden beneath the waves. You must journey there and undergo a trial. If your heart is pure and your will unbending, you shall prevail. And the true power of the Children of the Light shall be yours to command.
The true power?
The power to bring brightness to all things. To drive out darkness wherever it may be found. This is the true power of the light.
Yes! Then we must make our way there! Friends, to the Shrine of Scales!
Your Majesty, wait! I must seek further counsel first. Oh, Goddess! Velasco of the Children of the Night spoke to us of certain things. He would have us believe that the imprisonment of the Dark Dragon has caused our world's true nature to become distorted. This is why he plunged Yggdrasil into darkness, why he invites the Dark Dragon's return. Could it be true? Could the balance of our realm really have been corrupted?
Many, many eons ago, a pact was made. Shadroth and I were to maintain the balance of dark and light in our realm. But as our world matured, and monsters and humans grew greater in number, the darkness came to outweigh the light. Shadroth, having gained this advantage, brought forth yet greater and deeper darkness, and sought to bring the world entirely under his dark dominion. Together, the Children of Light and I fought to thwart his intentions, and after a long and arduous struggle, the Black Dragon was at last imprisoned. Then, in order that his dark power might not rise again, that he might never be awakened from his slumber, I created the world tree, Yggdrasil, who drinks in all the world's darkness, and within whose great veins that darkness becomes light. This is the true story of the struggle between light and dark, of the world tree's birth.
So, if Velasco's scheme succeeds, the Dark Dragon will reawaken, and the world will be plunged into darkness once more.
It will. And so the seal which binds him cannot be suffered to break. Child of Light, the fate of our world rests in your hands. You must free the world tree from the grip of the darkness, and prevent Shadroth's reawakening, no matter the cost. Alas, my physical form was lost in the last great battle with the Dark Dragon. As such, I am unable to fight beside you, to guide you as I would wish. However, the Circle of Light, in whose heart my power was sealed, will surely aid you in your quest.
The Circle of Light. That's the thing the Elven Elder was talking about.
Yeah, that's right. The thing that looks like Bluey's crown, isn't it? Where do you reckon we can find it, Your Holiness? Yes.
The Circle of Light. It, too, may be found in the shrine beneath the waves.
Superlative. Both the power of the light and its armlet can be obtained in an identical location.
In which case, we must depart with haste. This is not a time to be lingering superfluously.
I am not wrong. Every minute we waste, Yggdrasil grows weaker. And the seal binding the dark dragon with her.
Dear goddess, I give you our thanks. And a promise. I hereby swear that I shall overcome the trial and deliver our world from peril.
I truly believe that you will, my child. Now, you must go. But know that I watch over you. Always.
Alright, yeah, so that event played right into this next event automatically in the story, which I will show here in a second. After I finished talking about that event, that like was pretty important to what was going on and what happened in the past, and I just love the way they set that up and how they had the music going and everything. Everything played so nicely into that scene. So, yeah, just the whole music added to the atmosphere of that scene talking to the goddess's disembodied spirit. And then everything that you learned there was just, like, so awing the first time through the game. So, yeah. What you see in that picture, all I have to say is be afraid. Be very afraid. And the real knows what I'm talking about with that. So yeah, supposedly we have to go to the Shrine of Scales, not the Shrine of the Silver Monkey. And then follow it through the Jester's Court and into the Dark Forest. And beware of the Temple Guardians. Sorry there, just wanted to throw out a bit of a reference there. Yes, I was a fan of that show. Okay, so next scene. And this is where you find out what happened to the tower. And there's why to be afraid. It's a monster nearly as tall as the Pinnacle of Light.
Confound it! The Pinnacle of Light will not last long!
I must think. I must devise a counter-strategy.
Let it go, lad. It's already too late. Huh?
Get us out of here now!
Yeah. Those were my thoughts exactly, Brave. It's a monster of legend, essentially. They talk about it here in a moment, so... Oh, they don't. Damn. I think it was called the Bjornsson, or something like that. Hence the name of the, of the scene, the Big Bad Bjorn. It's basically a monster that was fabled to exist in, like, fairy tales and things. and used to scare kids and whatnot. Yes, yes, thank you, Real. The Behemoth, yes. Dragon Quest with its ridiculous names, yet again. Alright, so as you can see, we have a book icon over Genghis and the King here. And when you have a character with a book icon over them like this, that means you have to talk to them to advance the story. So as you can see, when I was playing and waiting for my friend before she gave me the go-ahead, I actually did not even talk to these guys so that I could show the talking to them on stream for advancing everything. So let's get this on the way. Bluey, where are you? The Wariv's bleeding, killing me. You ain't got any ideas where he might be, have ya? Places he likes to run off to while the mates ate, anything like that? Sadly not. He has never disappeared like this before. I cannot imagine where he might have gone. And now that I think upon it, despite our long acquaintance, I feel I know very little about him. Don't beat yourself up about it. It's often the way the closer you are to someone, the less you feel like you need to ask him stuff, ain't it? I reckon you know what's got into him. Everything's gotten into you. He's all broken, ain't he?
Yes.
I'm just trying to keep Angus in character there. He's not only Scottish, but he's a bit of a uneducated idiot because he was a thug, more or less. If this is so, we cannot leave him to suffer alone. After all, he finds solitude difficult at the best of times. You ain't wrong there. Well, leave it to me, I'll help you find the little bleeder. So he's like a Scottish with very little understanding of grammar and all that. So yeah, it makes for some very interesting dialogue and speech mannerisms, to say the least. Okay, so basically what those two scenes didn't show, yeah. Famous last words there, Brave. Real heroes don't need a plan, right? Stab! Yeah, it's like basically what they didn't show between those two scenes there is, after the whole scene with talking to the goddess, Helix runs away, and you don't know where the heck he went off to. And as I said, the one thing they didn't show in the scene with the Behemoth taking down the tower is where they actually discuss it, and they talk about it and mention its name and the fact that it was only ever talked about in fairy tales and legends. Alright, so now let's go talk to the king. Velasco, curse
you! Your Majesty!
Your Majesty, have you learned something more of our enemy?
Ah!
Indeed I have. I dispatched a messenger to the Elder of Sylvia after our encounter with that unconscionable rogue in Yggdrasil's crown. I requested that our elven friends search the annals for any mention of Velasco's name. And what news from the Elder? He tells me that a certain Velasco of the Children of Night was once a well-known sorcerer of unmatched talent. This was two long centuries ago, but the record of his deeds comes to an abrupt end. It seems that one ill-fated night, he razed his people's village, the home of his kith and kin, to the ground and disappeared. But why? Why destroy one's own people? Why indeed? Sadly, the annals offer little in the way of clues as to his motive. They do, however, hint at his having an unhealthy obsession with the powers of darkness. Perhaps his obsession became a fixation of madness, even. Perhaps he yearned to exploit those powers to bring the world under his command, just as Shadroth did so long ago.
I see.
And perhaps now, after 200 years, his plan is finally coming to fruition. If it is, it cannot be allowed to succeed. Indeed, it cannot, alas. We know not what form the next step of his nefarious scheme may take. So for now, all we can do is focus on claiming the true power of the light and coming to the aid of Allie and the World Tree, onward to the Shrine of Scales. I have my own intuition and beliefs about potentially what his home village was that he razed to the ground, but I'm not going to say anything. Alright, all of my heal stones are filled. So let's continue on. Okay, this is where the goddess told us to go, but I'm not sure how we are even supposed to find a submerged shrine, let alone get inside. Because I have a kind of sneaking suspicion that I'm potentially at least 80% right, and it could spoil anything for people that might watch or that might be watching live now or watch later in the recordings and ruin things for them. And I don't want to ruin things for myself either, so I'm just going to keep my thoughts to myself and lock them in the back of my head there. The stone clouds many things, but sadly, watertight's not one of them. Look there. Isla, would you bring us closer to the island over there? I feel something, a strange power emanating from beneath. Well, no, it seems our resident Child of Light is being guided to the shrine's entrance. Alright, I'll take us as close to the island as I can. Let me know when you're ready. Oh, we have a quest at granite. A quest at granite here. And give me a bigger item bag. A strange shrine at the bottom of the sea. Guarding the gatekeeper. While I wait for this, as long as this doesn't start advancing on its own, the other things I was saying before the mic was actually picking everything up was that I got like a couple of free games off of Steam. One of them is a visual novel that's been pretty funny and entertaining, and after I play through the entire thing to see how entertaining I consider it, I may potentially stream or record it to share with everyone. And then aside from that, I actually went and purchased the early access to Bunker Punks. And as I've unlocked more and more of the permanent stuff each time I've played through it and died and continued into another run of the game, it's actually gotten pretty fun and interesting. So I'll probably stream and or do some recordings of that as well. So you'll definitely be seeing Bunker Punks come up in some videos down the road, and maybe another game too. Just as kind of side projects. Cool blimey, Masaki. You got better eyes than me spotting a place like this all the way down here. Mariah Gambling Man. I would wager that these walkways lead directly to the Shrine of Scales. The Shrine of Skells. Thankfully, our monster friends seem yet to have arrived. We must make haste and earn this hallowed power before Velasco begins his inevitable meddling. Yes, Your Majesty, let us waste no time. Oh, looky! Yay, these were so fun. I don't know if you guys saw any of these in the parts of the Pinnacle.